Hello everyone, so we are now on week 8 ng ating math. So the topic for this week ay solve routine and non-routine problems involving the circumference of circle. So sa bilog daw, sa circumference, when you say circumference, it pertains to the distance around the circle. Okay, remember, distance around the circle. So halimbawa, let's say I have an object here. Let's say what I am bilog. Dito na lang. Hope you can see it. Okay. So let's say ito yung bilog natin. Okay. So let's say this is our circle. Now, what we have discussed before is meron siyang yung tinatawag na mga lines na naghahati sa kanya. So let's say lagyan natin siya ng line. So remember itong line na to. Okay. Okay, so yung line natin na yan, ang tawag natin dito sa haba ng diameter, sa haba nito ay diameter. Okay, diameter. Now, let's say from the center. Okay, kunyari yan yung center ng ating circle. And then, gumawa tayo ng line. So, from one point of the circuit going to the center, ang tawag naman natin dyan ay radius. Okay. Radius. So, ulitin natin ha. So, mula dito, let's say from this point, going to this point, we call that diameter. So, let's say from this point sa center, going to this point of the circuit, ang tawag naman natin doon ay radius. Okay? Tandaan nyo ha, magkaiba yun. So, yung mahaba, ito, ay diameter. Yung mula dun sa gitna, pupunta dun sa isang point around the circle, we call that the radius. Now, kung halimbawang itutuloy mo din yan, okay, so let's say from this point, pupunta dito sa center, this is radius, now if you're going to stretch the line to the other side, okay, kung nadiretso na yan, siya na ngayon ay diameter pa din, okay, kung diretso na. Basta nahati mo siya, basta hanggang dito lang, let's say from this point, punta dyan, okay, that is a radius. From this point, pupunta dito, still, that's a radius. Pero, kung gagawin mo, dadaan na yung line mo to the center, passing to the center, going to the other point in the circle, yun na ngayon ay diameter. So, pag-ibahin natin. Ang radius, itong radius natin, siya ay 2 times radius magiging diameter. Okay? Yung diameter naman, para maging radius, kunin mo yung kalahati ng diameter and then that will be the radius. So, ulitin natin para hindi kayo malito. Okay, sorry. Ulitin natin yung ating image. Okay. Again. Let's say dito. Parang tayo malito. Let's say ito yung circle natin. Ha? Let us assume this is our circle. Okay, so let's say ito yung center niya. Okay, so yun yung center. Yung line na dadaan all throughout the circle, all from one point of the circle to the other point, at dumaan siya sa center, ang tawag doon ay, so this is our center, ang tawag natin dito sa line na to ay diameter. Okay? Mula naman doon sa center, papunta sa isang point around the circuit, ang tawag naman natin dito ay radius. Okay? Ibig sabihin, ang radius natin, kung titignan nyo, ay kalahati lang ng diameter. Okay? Ngayon, para makuha mo naman yung given yung diameter, so kailangan mong kunin ngayon, yung diameter naman, siya naman ay dalawang radius para makuha natin siya. Paano ba yan? Let's make an example of the measurement. So, sukatin natin to using the centimeters. Okay? So, you can see in the ruler, so, that is mm, that is millimeters, yung maliliit. So, itong 1 na to, sila ay mga centimeters. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Ibig sabihin, the length of the diameter is 11, right? Guhin natin, lipat natin ng pwesto. Hindi makita dahil dun sa ilaw. Again, so ito ha. Yung ating, itong diameter nito ha, diameter. Ang haba ng diameter ay 11 centimeters. Okay? Ngayon, kung 11 centimeters yan, ano ngayon yung kanyang radius? Tandaan nyo, ang sabi natin, ang radius ay kalahati ng diameter. Kalahati, 1 half. So, kung meron kang 11, hahatiin mo siya. Ano ngayon yung haba ng radius mo? So, kunin mo yung kalahati ng 11. Diba? So, you have to look for 1 half of the diameter, which is 11. So, ano ba yung kalahati niya? So, kunyari, binari, kung may pera ka, if you have 11 pesos at maghahati kayong dalawa ng kapatid mo, tig magkano kayo? Okay? So, 550. Or, ibig sabihin, ang radius natin ay may value na 5 and 5 tenths centimeters. Okay? So, yan yung kanyang radius. Remember, ang diameter, 11 centimeters. So, ang radius, 5 and 5 tenths centimeters. Bakit? Kasi kinuha natin yung kalahati ng ating diameter. Lumabas itong ating radius. Okay? So, let's have a different example naman. So, we're trying to measure different sizes of circles para ma-distinguish natin yung sukat ng diameter at radius. So, let's say I have this small circle. Okay, let's try this one. Okay, so again, using the ruler, pwede nating kunin yung kanyang diameter. So again, to get the diameter, you need to start from zero. Okay. And then, going to the other side. So, kung makikita natin dun sa ating image, let's say siya ay nasa 7. So, ang diameter niya, so let's put the diameter in our circuit. So, let's say ito yung ating diameter. Assuming, so, itong diameter natin ay merong haba na 7 centimeters. So, kung ang diameter natin ay 7 centimeters, ano yun yung value ng ating radius? So, ang value ng radius natin ay, okay, so kunyari, meron kang 7 pesos, di ba? Hahadi kayong dalawang magkapatid, so tig kayo ay tig magkano? Okay, so ang magiging radius ay 3 and 5 tenths centimeters. Okay? Okay, so another example. This time, let's try to measure naman the radius kasi para maiba naman. So, I have here a can. So, subukan natin. Yeah, yung value ng radius niya at ng kanyang diameter. Okay? Let's get the center. So, let's say this is our center. Okay? So, let's try to measure the distance or the line from one point of the circuit to the other point. Okay. So, ayan. Kung makikita natin, siya ay nasa, sabihin natin, na nasa gitna, di ba? Nasa gitna siya. So, the value of the radius, okay, assuming, ha? Sorry, sobra. Okay. So, this is now the radius. Ang value ng ating radius ay, let's say, 4 and 5 tenths centimeters. So, if the value of our radius is 4 and 5 tenths centimeters, ano ngayon ang ating diameter? So, doblihin mo lang to. Yung value ng radius mo, you have to just double the value of it. So, yung 4 and 5 tenths, so doblihin mo, meron kang, okay, kunyari, meron kang 450 na pera, gagawin mong dalawa yon. So, meron kang 9 centimeters in this example. Okay? So, that's how you get the value of the radius and the diameter in relation to one another. Kasi maraming nalilito with the radius and the diameter. Remember, radius is one half of the diameter. So, from the center going to the one point of the circle, that is radius. Now, from one point of the circle passing through the center and going to the other side, you're going to connect the line there. We call that now the diameter. Okay? So, yun ang kanyang definition na. So, okay, mali dito. Okay, now, puntahan na natin ngayon yung pag-compute ng ating problem. So, subukan natin yung given sa ating module. So, let's try this one. Okay. A big metal dito tayo. So, a big metal ring with a diameter of 24 inches were cut and straightened. How long is the metal after being straightened? Ibig sabihin, binigyan tayo ng value ng diameter. So, what is the value of the diameter? Ayan o, diameter of 24 inches. So, kunin natin yun muna. Let's get that the data. So, gamitin natin. So, we have, so, sabi ha, the diameter is 24 inches. Okay? So, ano kung idediretso daw yung circumference niya, ano daw yung kanyang haba? CO meaning circumference of a circle. Now, remember, in answering word problems, meron tayo mga sinusunod na process. Okay, remember, so, meron tayong understand, meron tayong plan, and then, yung carry out the plan, that should be the solve, and then look back kung gusto mong tingnan kung tama ang iyong answer. Okay? So, ganun lang. So, what do we need to understand? So, understand, plan, and then solve, and then yung carry out. Ito yung, what do you call this? Look back or view. So, understand. So, sa understand, dyan sa yung tanong na what is asked. Okay, what is asked? Okay. And then, what are given? Sa plan naman, so, ang sabi dyan is, sa plan, dyan ay yung what is the operation and then the number sentence. Siyempre, yung S, that is solve. Dun sa solve, pwede mo yung sabihin na carry out the plan, ha? So, pwedeng ganun yan. So, gigila lang natin one word para madali ang matandaan. UPS. So, understand, plan, and then solve. You just have to solve. Okay? We will be using the data that we have here. So, the data that we have is the diameter is 24 inches. Ano daw yung kanyang circumference? Okay? So, ano daw yung circumference? Ano daw yung tinatanong? Ang tinatanong sa atin is, ano daw yung circumference? Next question. What are given? So, the given yung ating diameter, which is 24 centimeters. I mean, 24 inches. Okay? So, 24 inches. Tapos, plan. Yung plan, yung operation. So, syempre, we are going to use the formula in finding the circumference of the circle. Okay? So, ano ba yun? So, to get the circumference of the circle, meron tayong formula na sinusunod. And that is, follow my lead, circumference of a circle equals pi times diameter. Okay? So, ang basa natin dito ay pi. At ang pi ay equivalent na 3 and 14 hundredths. Dito ang gagamitin natin for all the problems that we will use in in answering word problems is the value of pi is 3 and 14 hundredths. Okay? So ano ibig sabihin nito? Kapag nakita niyo yung formula na walang symbol, that means that is pi times diameter or d. Okay? Ngayon, gagawin mo na naman is you just need to substitute the value of each of the letter in the problem. So, ulitin natin. Okay, so that's our given, yan yung given sa atin na problem. Okay, I hope hindi kayo masyadong nalilito dun sa ilaw na ginagamit ko. Sorry, medyo reflective kasi yung ibabaw nito. Okay. So, dito tayo. Burahin muna natin para hindi kayo malito. Okay. Again, dito natin ilagay para hindi kayo malito. This is pi. Ang basa ay pi. At siya ay may value na 3 and 14 hundredths. Okay. So, yun ang value ng ating pi. So again, to get the circumference of a circle equals pi times diameter. Okay? Ano yung value? You just have to get the value of the letters in our formula. So ano ba yung value ng pi? Ayun. Just get the value. 3 and 14 hundredths times d. Ano ba yung value ng ating d? Ayun. 24 inches. So times 24 inches. Okay? So, ang gagawin mo lang is you just have to multiply the numbers. So, ito tayo just say na to. So, we have 3 and 14 hundredths times 24. So, that would be 4 times 4, 16, the group 1. That's 5. Okay? Next, 4 times 3, we have 12. Okay, then multiply naman ito. So, 2 times 4, we have 8. We have 2, then we have 6. And then add, we have 6, 3, group 1, 5, 5. Wala na pala tayo. Wait, ipit natin ha. Wala na yung ating solution. Okay, so ito ay i-add natin, ha? So, ano ba? Put natin dito para hindi kayo malito, ha? Naubusan tayo ng space, eh. So, add lang natin yun. Okay, baka malito kayo kung bakit ganito, ha? Remember, ito yun, ha? Kinumpi lang natin kasi ayan yun. Okay? Para lang makita ninyo. So, we have 6. Okay, we have 13. The group 1. Just 5. And then, 7. And then yung pinag-aralan natin, if you can still remember the lesson that we have in the multiplying decimals, balikan nyo yung given, hanapin ang decimal point, o yung hatay yung decimal point, bilangin ang decimal place, 1, 2, dito wala, all in all, you have 2 decimal places, so, 1, 2, doon ang decimal point mo, so, 1, 2, decimal point, therefore, the circumference of the circle is 75 and 36 inches. Okay, so ito yung ating sagot. Okay. So, check lang natin. Now, you just have to make sure na tama yung pag-multiply natin. Ulitin natin. 4 times 4, that is 16. Take the 1. 4 times 1, that's 4. Plus 1, that makes it 5. And then 4 times 3, 12. Then 2 times 4, we have 8. 2 times 1, we have 2. And then 2 times 3, we have 6. Remember, ito, nire-write lang natin dito para makita nyo yung solution. So, kaya makikita nyo, hindi yan nakapantay dahil kinopy lang natin to. So, ayan. So, that's 6. 5 plus 8, that's 13. The group 1, 1, 2, and 3, that's 5. Then 1 and 6. That makes it 7. So, then, yung ating decimal point. So, kailangan dalawang decimal place siya. So, ito yung ating given. Ito na rin yung naging sagot. Ibig sabihin, the distance or the circumference of the circle with a diameter of 24 inches is 76 and 36 hundredths inches. So, ano ba yung ibig sabihin nun? Let's say, ito yung ating bilog. Okay? Kunyari, ito yung bilog natin. Tapos, kunyari, yung ang kanyang diameter ay yung given natin na 24 inches. Okay? Kung kukunin natin yung paligid niya, yung distance ng kanyang paligid, yun ay ang 76 and 36 hundredths meters. Yun ang ibig sabihin ng circumference. Yung paligid ng circle. And again, assuming lang ito ha. Kunyari, ito yung circle natin na mayroong diameter na 24 inches. So, to get the value of the circumference of the circle, you just need to multiply pi and the diameter. So, you get the value of pi, 3 and 14 hundredths, ito yung, times 24 inches, which is yung value ng ating diameter. So, multiply lang. Then, sumagot ay, maging sagot ay, ito, 75 and 36 hundredths inches. Okay. So, sa different example, gamitin natin yung ating problem kanina. So, if you can still remember yung circle natin kanina, yung isang circle, okay, yung isang circle ay mayroong diameter, ang sukat ay 11 centimeters. Okay? So, kung ang diameter 11 centimeters, ano yung value ng radius? The value of the radius ay 5 and 5 tenths centimeters. Okay? In this case, ang gagawin lang muna natin is turuan ko kayo kung paano kukunin yung circumference. Ha? So, in answering the word problems, so, balikan nyo lang yung mga naging lesson natin in answering or in understanding word problems para makapag-focus tayo doon sa circumference. Okay? So, let's write this one. The diameter is 11 centimeters, so the radius is 5 and 5 tenths centimeters. Okay? So, kukitin natin. The circumference of a circle equals pi times diameter. Okay? So, ano yung value ng pi? Ayun. 3 and 14 hundredths times ano yung value ng d? 11 centimeters. Okay? So, multiply lang natin. Let's go to this part. So, 3 and 14 hundredths times 11. So, copyin lang natin. 4, 1, 3. And another 4, 1, 3. Add. So, we have 4 We have 5. We have 4. Then we have 3. Okay. So check natin na. This is 4, 5, 4, and then 3. So ibig sabihin, the circumference of the circle is 34 and 54 hundredths centimeters. Okay. So yan yung ating circumference ng circle na mayroong diameter na 11 centimeters. Okay. So isa pa, ito naman yung magiging kaiba doon sa ginagawa natin ng ganito. Why? Kasi in finding the circumference of the circles, meron tayong dalawang formula. Unang formula na ginagamit natin ay CO, or circumference of the circle equals pi times diameter. Meron pa kasing isang formula. Ang isang formula ay CO, or circumference of the circle equals 2 times pi, sorry, 2 times pi times R. Or pwede rin sabihin na 2 pi R. Okay, so again, 2 times pi times R, or 2 pi R. Paano ba yun? Okay. Let's use this example. So the radius is 5 and 5 tenths centimeters. So gamitin natin yun. So the circumference of a circle equals 2 pi R. Now, bakit itong formula na ito ginamit ko? Remember, ang given sa atin ay kunyari yung radius. Let us assume na kunyari, hindi na binigay sa atin yung value ng diameter. Walang value ng diameter na binigay sa atin. Ang binigay sa atin ay ang value ng radius. So, 5 and 5 10 centimeters. So, yun ang gagamitin natin ngayon. So, 2 pi r. So, you just need to get the value. So, since ang 2 ay 2, times, ano ba yung value ng pi? 3 and 14 hundredths. Times, ano ba yung value ng radius? 5 and 5 tenths centimeters. Okay? Multiply mo lang yan. Remember, tatlong number yan. 2. So, we have the 2. We have the 3 and 14 hundredths. And then, we have the 5 and 5 tenths. So, pwede kang pumili muna ng dalawang number na pwede mong i-multiply para mas maging madali sa'yo. So, in my case, so let's say, yung 2 at yung 5 and 5 tenths, multiply mo muna. So, that will give you 11 centimeters. Diba? So, katapos, balik ko na. Kung matatandaan nyo yung ginawa natin dito kanina, yun din yung magiging sagot naman dyan. So, mangyayari, 3 and 14 hundredths times 11 centimeters, kung ano yung computation natin kayo na dito, yun pa din yung lalabas na sagot. Okay? So, ganun yung nangyari sa kanya. Okay. Try naman natin na iba talaga yung given. So, bigyan tayo ng example. Okay? So, let's say the value of the radius being given to us is, let's say, 8 centimeters. Okay? So, anong gagamitin natin ng formula? Ito bang formula na ito? O ito bang formula na ito? Tingnan nyo mabuti, ha? Okay. So, ang gagamitin natin ay ito, hindi ito. Bakit? Kasi ang given sa atin ay radius. Dito, gagamitin mo lang to kapag ang given ay diameter. Eh, ang given sa atin ay radius, eh. So, ito ang gagamitin natin. 2 pi r. Okay. So, let's do that. So, circumference of a circle equals 2 pi r equals ulit. This is number 2 times. Ano yung value ng pi? Ito. 3 and 14 hundredths times. Ano yung value ng r? Ayun. 8 centimeters. Okay. So, again, tatlong number yan. So, 2, 3 and 14, and then 8 centimeters. Pili ka muna ng dalawang number na madaling i-multiply. So, you can use yung 2 at yung radius. So, 2 times 8, that will give you 16. So, 16 centimeters. Okay? So, gamitin mo na ngayon na 16 centimeters times 3 and 14 hundredths. Okay, so try natin mag-multiply dito. So, 3 and 14 hundredths times 16. So, 6 times 4, that will give you 24, group 2. 6 times 1 plus 2, that's 8. That's 18. 6 times 3 kasi 18. Since 1 to, copy na lang. 4, 1, 3. So, again, dahil wala din nakita sa screen, move lang natin, ha? So, 4, baba lang natin. So, that's 4. 8 plus 4 makes it 12. Balikan natin na. So, ito yan, ha? 4. So, let's make it 12. Regroup 1 doon. 1 plus 8 plus 1, that's 10. Regroup 1. So, nire-rewrite ko lang dito, ha? Para makita nyo kasi maliit na yung screen natin dito. So, 0. And then, 1 plus 1 plus 3, that is 5. So, 5. Okay? And then, balikan yung factors. Tandaan, meron tayong decimal point at dalawang decimal place. So, pagdating sa sagot, 1, 2, decimal point. Okay? Meron decimal point. So, that makes it 50 and 24 hundredths centimeters. So, the circumference of the circle is 50 and 24 hundredths centimeters. So, this is our answer. Okay? So, I hope naintindihan. If you're having difficulty, balikan na lang ang ating lesson. So, thank you and bye-bye.